Hello everyone, now today we are here to do an experiment in physics. Aim of this experiment is establishing the relation between the loss of weight of a solid when fully immersed in tap water and strongly salty water, with weight of the water displaced by it by taking at least two different solids. Let's discuss some theory related to this topic. Here we will prove the Archimedes principle. According to Archimedes, when a body is fully or partially immersed in a liquid, then a force is acting on this body. This force is known as an upthrust force. And due to this upthrust force, the weight of the body decreases when it is immersed in the liquid. According to Archimedes, the decrease in the weight of the body is equals to the weight of the displaced liquid. Here we will prove this Archimedes principle. Material required to do this activity are one weighing machine, beaker, stirrer, spring balance, weight or any body that have the weight, salt, measuring cylinder, some water. Now let's start the activity. First of all, we will use the spring balance to find out the weight of the body that we are using in this experiment. On the spring balance, we can measure the weight in two units, one in the Newton and second one in the gram force. We will here take the readings in the gram force scale. In the gram force scale, the 5 divisions is equals to 100 gram force. It means one division is equals to 100 upon 5 and it is equals to 20 gram force. It means the least count in the gram force scale is 20 gram force. Now I have adjusted the point with the help of this zero adjustment at the zero. It means there is no zero error in this case. Now I am using this spring balance to find out the weight of the body. I will use this hook to hold the body and I will see the reading in the spring balance. Now you can see the reading in the spring balance is 300 gram force. It means the weight of the body in the air is 300 gram. Now I am immersing this body into the measuring cylinder fully, which have the water in it. Now when I will immerse the body in the water, then I will note down the reading in the spring balance. Here now the reading is 300 gram force. After immersing it, we will see what happens to the weight of the body. Now you can see, now my body is partially immersed and the weight of the body is, you can see, 280 gram force. It is not at the 300, it is 280 gram force. Now when I am immersing fully in the water, now we will observe the reading of the spring balance. You can see that now the reading in the spring balance is 260 gram force. It means now the weight of the body when it is fully immersed in the water is 260 gram force. Now we will note down these observations in the table. Here the zero error of the spring balance that we are using is 0 gram force. recorded weight of the body is 300 gram force. When I have hanged the body with spring balance in the air. Now, the actual weight of the body in air is recorded weight minus zero error. It means 300 gram force minus 0 gram force. So it is equals to 300 gram force. Now, the recorded weight of the body in the water, we have calculated it as 260 gram force. Actual weight of the body in water is equals to recorded weight minus zero error. It means 260 gram force minus 0 gram force. And it is equals to 260 gram force. Now, the apparent loss of weight of body in water, we can calculate it by actual weight in air minus actual weight in water. Actual weight in air that we have calculated 300 gram force. And actual weight of the body in water is 260 gram force. It means 300 gram force minus 260 gram force. And it is equals to 40 gram force. It means the apparent loss of water. It means apparent loss of weight of the body in water is 40 gram force. Now we will prove it that whether it is equals to the displaced water or not. Let's do the next part of our activity. Now this beaker I will use to collect the displaced water when I will fully immerse the body in the water. So, I am measuring the weight of this empty beaker. So, now the reading of the weighing machine is zero. When I will place this empty beaker on the weighing machine, now the reading is 164.9 grams. That is approximately equals to 165 grams. Now, the next step, this measuring cylinder in which I will immerse the body, I am filling this measuring cylinder to the top level. Now, you can see the water I have filled in the measuring cylinder to the top level. Now, next step, I am immersing the body in the water, that is in the measuring cylinder, and I will collect the overflowing water. Now I am immersing the body in the water. You can see the body is fully in the water, and due to it has displaced the water from the measuring cylinder, which was completely filled to the top level. Now, in the next step, we will calculate the weight of the beaker having the displaced water. Let's measure the weight of the beaker having the displaced water in it. You can see that it is equals to 204.8 grams. If I will round off it, then I can take it as 205 grams. Now let's do the calculation. So the weight of the empty beaker is 165 gram force. The weight of the beaker plus displaced water is 205 gram force. So the weight of the displaced water, we can calculate it as weight of the beaker with water minus weight of the empty beaker. So we will do 205 gram force minus 165 gram force, and it is equals to 40 gram force. It means the apparent loss of the weight of the body in water is 40 gram force, and the weight of the displaced water is 40 gram force. It means here we have proved our Archimedes principle. Now we will do the second step of this activity, where we will prove the Archimedes principle for the salt water. Here again we are using the same body which have the weight in the air is equals to 300 gram force. Now we will dip this body in the salty water. So to make this water salty, I am adding salt in the water. Now I am dissolving the salt in the water by stirring, because we know that with the stirring we can increase the solubility. Now we will note down the weight of the body in the salt water. For that I am immersing this body in the water. You can see its weight in the air is 300 gram force. Now when I will immerse it in the salt water, now full body is immersed in the salt water, and see the reading of the spring balance. It is equals to 240 gram force. So the weight of the body in the salt water is 240 gram force. Now I will note down this observation in the observation table. Here we are using the same spring balance and same body, so that's why the zero error of the spring balance is 0 gram force and the actual weight of the body in air is 300 gram force. Now the recorded weight of the body in the salt water is 240 gram force. Actual weight of the body in the salt water is recorded weight minus zero error. It means 240 gram force minus 0 gram force, and it is equals to 240 gram force. Apparent loss of weight of the body in the salt water is actual weight in air minus actual weight in salt water. So 300 gram force, which was the actual weight in air, minus 240 gram force, which is the weight of the body in the salt water. And if we will do the calculation, then I will get 60 gram force. It means the apparent loss of the weight of the body when it is fully immersed in the salt water is 60 gram force. Now I am immersing this body in the salt water. The measuring cylinder is completely filled with the salt water at the top level. When I will immerse the body, then the water will displace from the measuring cylinder. Now you can see the full body is in the salt water, and we have collected the displaced water in the beaker which have the weight 165 grams. Let's measure the weight of the beaker having the displaced salt water in it. It is equals to 224.5 gram force. So we will note down in the observation table. Weight of the beaker plus displaced salt water is equals to 224.5 gram force, and I am taking it as 225 gram force. Now the weight of the displaced salt water we can calculate it by weight of the beaker with salt water minus weight of the beaker. Because we are using the same beaker, so its weight will be remain same, that is 165 gram force. So weight of the beaker with salt water, that is 225 gram force, minus weight of the empty beaker, that is 165 gram force. If I will subtract it, I will get 60 gram force. It means the apparent loss of the weight of the body in the salt water, that is 60 gram force, and it is equals to weight of the displaced salt water, that is also 60 gram force. It means here we have proved the Archimedes principle for the salt water also. So from this activity we have proved that the Archimedes principle holds for every liquid, which says that the loss of the weight in the liquid is same as the weight of the displaced liquid. I hope this activity is clear to you and you have enjoyed it a lot. Thank you so much.